marks the beginning of something new in the country, where the youth, the Niger Delta youth, starting from the youth of River State, are coming together from different society groups, different cults, different unions, to come together as one. They decided to lay down their weapons, they decided to lay down, surrender their guns, and listen to what the government and other people of the country have to say. They have been here for 8 days, and they have gone through so many trainings, they have gone through so many reorientation, and it has been something they claim has been very worthwhile.
The River State Governor, His Excellency Peter Odili, found listening ears amongst the groups as he succeeded in convincing all the factors to come together to form lasting peace in the country in Sherry Hill Camp, Jos, under the supervision of Dr. Judith Asuni.
Yes, I know that I'll be speaking the mind of all of us here. And our mind is that we have made peace. Is it not true? Our mind is that the government have succeeded in bringing us together. Is it not true? Then we have message from the government too, that now that we are one. Is it not true? Is it not true? Okay, let us begin to count back. From the first day we came here, there are some of our friends, our brothers here. We cannot even look at their face. They don't even look at our face. Is it not true? But today, we are eating together. We are bathing together. We are sleeping together. So it means we are heading somewhere. Are we heading somewhere?
Yes!
Niger Delta youth, are we heading somewhere?
Yes!
We are heading somewhere.
Yes.
Then it means if the government have succeeded in their plans to bring us together, let us clap for the government.
Yes.
Let us clap for the government.
Yes.
But now we have message for the government. We have message for the government. And I know that we all agreed that the government should hear this message. What is our message for the government? Our message for the government is that we will no longer fight ourselves again. As Niger Delta youth, we will never, never, never fight again. Is that not the message? And what is the message? If there must be a fight, if there must be a fight, and anybody that is not forbidding his own part of the bargain, that the Niger Delta youth are saying, if the government will not do what they are supposed to do, they are our enemies. Is that not true? That we will never, never fight ourselves again. We have realized our mistakes. We have amended our mistakes. And we have said to ourselves, you are my brother, you are my friend. Is that not true?
That's true.
We have been shaking hands together now. And maybe they want to see proof. Can we all get up and embrace one another, please? Get up and embrace one another. Should keep to their own part of the bargain. Is that what you are saying?
Yes.
We are sincere. We are very, very sincere in making peace. We have made peace. We shall not turn back. If anybody comes to tempt us, let him go and send his children first. That's our agreement.
Yes,
our agreement that our agreement is that before you send us message, send your children first.
Yes.
Because we will not fight. You will not bribe us. You will not give us money to rig election for you. Is that not what we said?
Yes.
You will not give us money to cause confusion in our community. Is that not what we said?
Yes.
You will not give us money to fight our brothers. Is that not what we said?
Yes.
That is what we said.
Yes.
So if you want these things, you want us to fight, you want us to kill ourselves, go and look at your house first. And we said another thing. Our leaders, we elected them. We put them there. The House of Assembly. Common Evil Councillor. Common Evil Councillor will wind up his glass. And we that elected them and suffered for them and fought for them and died for them. When they get into power, we cannot see them again. We are saying we don't want it again. Is that not true? We are saying they are supposed to be serving us. They are supposed to be serving us, not we serving them. That is what we agreed. And because we have agreed, we shall not turn back. Every one of us here, every Niger Delta youth here is represented. And we know that we're not turning back. Is that not what we said?
Yes.
Is there anybody that will turn back?
No.
Is there anybody that is not convinced that we have changed?
We've changed.
Everybody is sure that we have changed.
Yes.
Yes. Because from the first day here, we're not talking to ourselves. And before the day will go on, we started a little bit, we started greeting ourselves. The following day, it's as if one side should play their own game, the other side play one. The next thing, we come into football. And well, that's my team, what's the name?
Integrity.
We were supposed to win, but they give us 1-0. But they tried.
Performing Musicians Employers Association of Nigeria, PIMAN, has been very concerned about the situation in the Niger Delta and the destruction of both lives and properties, and so have decided to be a part of the peacekeeping initiative through creating channels of communication and an atmosphere for positive social interactions and integrations with music as a central and basic unifying force. Also, by creating an enabling environment for continual peaceful relations with all relevant stakeholders in the state of Rivers, one that will impact positively in the lives of all, as well as attract opportunities for new investment, in addition to ensuring solid and sustainable development in the state. The executives of PIMAN visited Cherry Hill to encourage the peace dialogue already happening there and to boost these young men in the positive ways they can. To PIMAN, this is only the beginning of more peaceful initiatives to come.
I want to thank all of us for even coming for this program. We want to thank Charlie Boy that he was able to come down here to see us. It means we are people.
Yes.
For Charlie Boy to come down here and see us, it means we are important.
Yes.
But we want to say one thing. We want to say with empty regret that people sent us to this place and they did not come to visit us. We don't like it, but we have forgiven them. We don't like it, but we have forgiven. Yes, we don't like it, but we have forgiven them. So, on behalf of the Niger Delta youth, I am saying that Niger Delta has been reformed. And Niger Delta will get back the name Garden City. Is that not true?
Yes.
So let us give 3 gunshots to Niger Delta. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for changing and remaining changed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So as I enter here today, the first good news is say reconciliation don't happen. People now, they move among the youth, they talk to each other. You see any old man here? Any old man there, Mogul, huh? Wait then. So, When the politicians, they don't bring the money, they still say, these people, they need to organize. How will we inside them? They go carry five, settle them. Carry five, the other side, settle them. We say, now you get power now. Now you get power. Then we go begin fight ourselves.
Where we go take talk, where people go hear us, na dialogue. That power where we don't get before, we don't get them through this unity.
I will trust them, I said that. Because when 2,000 people come out, they go fight war. And only 10 come back wounded, they don't get nothing come back. What happened to those ones? They don't perish now. Can the 10 form the multitude of army? They cannot.
Peace, that be the thing where they talk about. As we don't start that peace here, that peace not going to depart us in Jesus' name. Rastafari!
Yes, Raja
Teta! We came here for rehabilitation of our youth.
Now we have agreed. We are not going back anymore. Nobody's carrying arms anymore. All the arms have been submitted. And we have vowed not to do it anymore. And as we go back, we are also going to educate the ones left behind. We are going to lecture them and educate them. Everyone will have to get to repent. We have to repent and start a complete new life.
In my experience, I sent them to the state government. And the federal government will arrange the program.
We lost over the interline. But thank God we have realized ourselves and come together.
Great Pupu!
Yes!
Great Papa!
Yes!
Everybody say Gigi!
As I come in here, as you say, now so correct people full everywhere. As you say, when I don't take on a hand, the thing where it be me like say I for tell on and I don't take on a hand, talk to myself, so now don't settle on myself. I be not so. But me and all of us, as we don't agree, we're here to make peace. Because, like my brother talked, our mumu don't do. We're here to move forward.
I see it falling, the walls of Babylon. I see them falling, by the wayside, oh yeah. They came to school us with their brainwashed education. They came to teach us their own way. That will split us apart. We don't need no Babylon law. For it's mommy. All we know is their Ten Commandments. The Babylon law could be twisted anyway. But it's in Ten Commandments. You don't have to escape. I just want it. I want it. I do the want anyway. Oh, Papa, I want it. I want it. I do the want anyway. Repeat. You say, want it. I want it. I just you the want anyway.
Is this thing, you know, not be sure we just come here, broke grammar, go, no, man. We will still come see you now with the governor. Make we know who won the raid from the agreement. I go monitor with my mouth, now my mouth with my power. You go hear them for song. You go hear them for paper. So this kind of accord we will get, not be accord we go joke with. So when I come then, I know say big party good day.
Thank you, your house, your house, your house, your house. Great pleasure, Delta.
Zoom.
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 Zoom. Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom.
from the standard of Europe to the popularity of America. The style and uniqueness of Asia. And even the beauty and naturalness of Africa. Lomé Region Abuja fits in pleasurably into your different worlds.
They should now go back and prepare a skill acquisition for these people to do. If they do it, I don't think we have problem. And not only doing skill acquisition after learning, they should be empowered. If somebody should go and do an apprenticeship, after apprenticeship, at least should be given some little money to establish. If this is done, I don't think anybody has any cause to carry on. Like most of us who are undergraduates, we don't have any cause, but because we are dropped behind, and this has made us to be going about carrying these boys who have been committing all these things. But now that we have agreed, we are not going back anymore.
We should thank our government to bring us like this. We thank God that peace still reigns for Niger Delta. Today, we thank God. But one thing again, I want the government to know. Some of our brothers are under detention. Make government try, for peace sake, release all our brothers. Lower state, outside state, make government try, for the sake of peace, make them release all our brothers, so that we will unite as one. Because if we go very wrong, when some people take detention, some people they just say peace, peace. Those who are in detention are not going to be too happy. So make government try for us, release all our brothers in detention. And again, I'm not advising our advice government. This program where they try bring us come. May they invite the commissioners, House of Assembly, House of Senate, and some other personnel. May they take on this program. So we will learn from the people they teach us to. So we will learn how to maintain peace in our society. And not because they bring us here, and those people will still commit us again with small 1 naira. All those things, you know what, make all those things exist again. So may they invite those who made them say they come to for this very training.
I'm Philip Thompson from Asaritalo local government.
How is the food?
The food. Really, you know, this is calm doing. You have to endure whatever thing they give you because I believe it's a training they are giving us. I don't count it as a bad thing in school. They are building us.
So the training, why is the training? You read,
write? Really, they taught us about leadership, method about leadership, how we are going to manage our resources, that is, on business and other things. So really, they did not provide any writing material for us. All the teaching was just verbal. We asked them that this is not the right way for them to teach us. They said later they will provide the booklets and all those things for us. They said every little step in life is good. What they taught us, I believe, is good. And in every trade, in every trade, that we pray God that what they have taught us shall embed in us so that we will lean forward to see the progress of Malawi.
Okay, so say you go back now and the government decides to embed the new people in it. What would you go to do? What kind of work or job would you want?
I was trained in many fields. I'm a welder. For the past years, I just learned those things, and there was no job for me. Well, another said, an angry man is an angry man. Then the Chinese people said, it is not good for his father to give his child a fish to eat, but teach him how to kill the fish. So the government, or the Niger Delta, they should teach us how to kill the fish, not to give us fish to eat every day. So going back to Port Harcourt or to Oasis, they should give us something to do, not to leave us this way, because after this training, we'll go back to Port Harcourt and we are still as we are. Things will get worse more than, because I know from different groups we are united and we are going to face one focus, one mind. So if really before they thought, we know everything is from the government, if before they thought by separating us, fighting against ourselves, the government will gain. Today, I believe this camp, they have brought us together in unity, and as we are going, we are in unity in peace. I believe nothing will happen in Port Harcourt, even in Niger Delta. But since if they do not want to do anything for us, you know, we all are facing the same focus, and the government will find it very difficult this time, because before it was one or two groups that is facing the government, but now all the Niger Delta youths will face the government. So the best thing for them to do is to take care of us, so that the country will move forward.
All the politicians, not because of their own selfish interest or their own personal motive, go on and buy guns for us, for you to use it to destroy ourselves. No, they should neither think of good things to motivate us. Create good footballs. There are companies around us in River State. We have good oil companies that can make good things for us. For instance, football competitions, or not even just football teams. If they can pull up the companies, the multinationals, if we have less than at the moment, we have over 300 companies. If 50 companies can have a football team of 20 players, you can imagine the capacity or the number, and they will be paying, they will be occupying them. Morning and evening, they will go to training to keep their memory busy and their thinking busy. They have focus because they are playing from that. They are ending up salary there than are buying guns for us to use it to kill ourselves. We are not asking them to just bring money for us, because giving us money to eat today will not boost our own livelihood by the end of the day. But for them to make sure, not today they will come here and say, we should write an MOU for them, what do we want? Some people, actually we need so many things. Good handwork, technical works. Some people want to do businesses. Encourage them. But where are we going to end?
I don't see you now.
I won't go up for the rapid too.
Are they come on?
You relax, and even the way you eat and enjoy. Low merit in Abuja, we promise our customers a unique hotel experience.
Yes, we've been here for about 7 days now. From the day when we came, it was like child's play. You know, we thought it was not going to work. You know, everybody was minding itself.
Okay.
Before the day we go off, before the day two, we found out that we were sleeping together. We started eating together, we played together. We do a lot of things together. If you see most of our pictures, we are complete. Everybody, there is no cult, there is no this, there is no that. Everybody is saying one mouth. And finally, we have agreed. Everybody has agreed. Every unit, everybody that is presented here has agreed that we're not going to fight ourselves again in the Niger Delta. The youths will never fight again in the Niger Delta. But if the government, after succeeding in bringing us together, will not do for us what we are supposed to be getting as citizens of the Niger Delta, then the youths will fight the government. That's our agreement. Is that not what we said?
That's exactly
what we have agreed. That we're not going to fight again. We're not going to make any problem with ourselves. But if the government will not do what they ought to be doing, then they are our enemies. There are things we are expecting the government to do for us. We expect that we have good roads. We expect that we have good roads. We expect that those that are qualified to have jobs, should be given jobs. We expect that. Then there are things like water that we need. Scholarship. Most of our boys here are graduates. They are graduates. And most of the people we put in power, like the commissioners, House of Assembly members, when they enter their cars, they put tinted glasses, we cannot see them again. We are saying if we put you in power and you tint up your glass for us not to see you again, you will miss that glass. We don't want tinted glass again in River State. In Niger Delta, there should be no tinted glass. Our leaders should be our servants. They should serve us so that we can follow suit. That is what we have agreed on. Yes, and there are communities that have been destroyed. Our communities. We are thanking God now they are bringing us back. We have agreed to come back. What we are interested in is our unity. And that's what we've gotten. If the government want to do anything for us, that's their business. But we are saying the government should try to be sincere in their own part. In our own part, you can see us, we are sincere. My brothers that I cannot embrace before, my friends I cannot embrace before, we can embrace ourselves now. You understand? So, we sleep in one room, we eat in one plate, and then we are okay.
Together.
The Niger Delta people, we are focused not to fight again. We are focused. We are promising the government we will never fight ourselves again. They talked about rebuilding the places were spoiled. Rebuilding the places they were spoiled. We are saying that's not our business for now. But because there is a new start, we are starting a new Niger Delta. The youths will not fight again. So those that want to build can come in and build. We are saying they should come in and build. They should come in and invest. We want to make sure that no more touts in Niger Delta, no more guns in Niger Delta. So the government is free to come into Niger Delta and do their building. We have kept our own bargain of the peace. We have come together, we have dropped our wake-up weapons, we shall not fight again. So we are pleading that the government should do their own. They know what is their own. Let them build Niger Delta back.
And today we all in this camp, from all the opposite side and everything, we all agreed to come under one umbrella. But I want to appeal to the famous state government and federal government, it should not be wise after putting us together this way. Because we all are coming from different camp and creek, from the creek. So we're going back home, staying idle, definitely an idle man is a devil worship. So we will appeal to government to please look for something. And I have a graduate, the other graduates or other graduates here, the other skilled workers here, they should look for something and then we have enough investment in Niger Delta that we can all fix into. We have students here that they're not in school, but we need to finance and everything, they cannot be in school. They should provide scholarship and everything, scholarship scheme, and I'll do everything for them. And by so doing, you cannot see me tomorrow, maybe if I have a job tomorrow, maybe I'm going to work in the morning, then maybe one person will come and meet me, or come with a, there's a job, so please come and do a job for me. Eventually, if I'm not working, I'll go and do it. But if I don't want to do it, I'm going to work. I will not have time for that. And peer groups, idleness, we call it peer groups, this thing started with peer groups and so on. So what I believe of our government that as I'm going back, they should not let us be idle. They should try and get one or two things for us to be doing.
Have plan, another thing is to execute it. When you have your plan and know where to execute it, you are like a dreamer. So the government has made the youth so redundant for so long. So I am saying that as we are going back, the government who has sent us here shouldn't allow those that have come here for this cause to be wayward again in the streets. The youths are committed, but government should play their part.
Alright, so when you go out there, I believe that how you intend to remind and teach others that are not here about the leadership skills and benefits.
I think I am suggesting that the government should open an office for all those that come for this orientation, because we all came from different local government areas and clans. They should open an office for us so that we too can impart what we have learned to others that are not here. And also,
to make sure that we would have come to really build our people and make them to understand. And the government should support us in every angle. In every angle, so that we too keep ourselves busy.
This lecture, please process it. The lectures that we've been having, how has it
gone? Anyway, there's no problem with the lectures.
Have you gained anything?
We only have one or two things. I experienced one or two things which I don't have the experience before.
Such as?
Like the sport event, go through the rock, climbing the rock, even as the layman explaining how it is. Those things I don't have the experience before, at least. With my coming for the peace program, at least, I have the experience of it, which I can testify by the time I get back to River State.
As a leader, do you have plans when you go back to River State to implement what you learned to teach other people that you
learned? Actually, yes, I will do. Actually, I will do. I don't think I've been done well for those that are not there. I'll explain to them, at least put them through one or two things. I will do.
Do you have any plans to see the government about this, government of the state, about this recreation thing? Do you have your own committee that will go and present this to the government?
Actually, I'm supposed to be in government house, please, to have one or two advice from him, because by right, he's supposed to visit us, but with the consequences beyond his control, he couldn't come, according to them. So our plan is to go there, at least all of us that have come here for the peace program, to go there, at least one advice, one or two for them. And also we have, like our young youth, we have in their minds, and we have something to say, like about any of our boys, anywhere, maybe in the station, maybe those in the yard, those in dice, we know at least what has happened, but anywhere they have apprehended them, but they should leave them so that they can come and join the need for the peace. Because wherever they are, they know that you have made peace. So we want them to release them. Even in Abuja, those in state, those in Kaduna, wherever they have taken them to, we want all them to release so that we know actually the peace have come to River State.
To be honest, what we have gained from this thing is the togetherness of Ijaw youths. You know, before this time, even though the umbrella body, the Joint Youth Council, is there are still sleeper organizations. And in the process, government, so to say, announced some groups to topple all the good ideas of IYC. But today, we are together as brothers, and we are forging ahead. We've learned from our past mistakes. And we believe strongly that united we stand and divided we fall.
There will be no soul that will be lost again. Yes. But you shall do it without violence.
Yes.
Martin Luther King conquered America with non-violence, and he's still remembered, and he'll be remembered next week. And you too shall be remembered, and a memorial shall be written on you that during this time, the Niger youth guys came and did their thing, sat in jaws, cut the cord, healed the cord, embrace one another and shook their hands together. And I want to say this prayer to you. Our Father, I ask that these people that have started here will go from strength to strength, from power to power. Yeah. That you will sustain and keep them. Yeah. That they will eat the fruit of the land. And they will have plenty. And they shall also give the people, because that will have sufficiently blessed them. I pray that none of them shall see death. I pray that none of them shall be marginalized. And I pray that the power of the Holy Spirit will fall mighty upon them. Nothing shall be done among them, because I ask in the only name that is above every name, the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Great, 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 great,
Welcome back. Now that has been interesting for me, and I hope it has been very interesting for you as well. You know, it's always more refreshing when you learn a thing or two a day. I have learned, and I have learned that peace has no rival. Peace is very, very important in our lives. And we'd like to use the opportunity to thank the governor of River State for bringing this very, very nice initiative. We'd also like to thank the government for supporting this initiative. And we'd also like to thank PNAN for coming together to support a worthy cause. So until next week, when we come your way again, same time, same station, keep watching Zoom Time. My name is Helen Sosu. Bye-bye.
This is Niger, Niger, country, country, country.
This one for those people when they say they could destroy this country and find their way. One day now, one day. Father is sleeping.
for marketing money, our money come better. No more starving, we come, they eat five times a day. But all this no go work until we come together as one. One heart, one hope and one people. Some of our leaders must to change from bad to good. Stop corruption, stealing and embezzling. A Papa Varo Danaide has the sequence done so. A Papa Varo Danaide find solution. Continue when they grow, no kill and more.
The movers and the shakers, the opportunity to highlight the achievements so far. So be a part of Zoom Time Phenomenon and write to the producers, number 2 Ajilagon Street, Bagara, Lagos, or call 080-330-76993. For a transcript or a copy of this broadcast, you can also call or write the producers of Zoom Time.
Africa Independent Television.
Are we happy in here? Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, welcome with me. The award winner for Channel O 2003 Best African Gospel Artist. The Wakening Ball of Africa. The Prince of the Niger Delta. Put your hands together.
Time is a slow and steady Niger Delta move. You just stretch your body a little. Bah, like this. Yeah, get bah, like this. Uh-huh. Yeah. This is an Ijo song. It says, God, you do well for me. Let's show God some appreciation, yeah. Let's go together. I was singing the joy. And now we give me a take this music to another level. All you need to say is amen, hallelujah, hosanna. Are you with me tonight? Before I leave the stage tonight, let's do it together. Everybody say amen, oh. Gentlemen, good night. I will see you again. If you want more of this music, go to the market and buy the tape.
Television.
Africa Independent Television.
AIT, AIT, the communication of the TV for this country, they make ready to be.
Africa Independent Television.
AIT, AIT, the communication of the TV for this country, they make ready to be.
AIT, sharing the African experience.
As we continue our series on African American